Hello everyone, we are in Marco's basement. That's exactly where the album was born, because here is where we put together ideas and demos and we start to write lyrics. Through this journey, eyes are burning, but we're not slowing down. This is like our personal studio, because here is where we put together all the ideas and Marco writes the music, getting inspired by TV. After Mark was pretty much done with the basics of the music for a new Lacuna Coil song, he sends the files to us, because nowadays it's easier through internet. We can get like MP3s at home, just listen to the music, and we can start to sing over the music and put down ideas. So the songs are going to every member of the band and Andrea and I for the lyrics. We record the ideas and we come here to this little basement studio and we just record it. We just like stay in front of the microphone and just like throw every ideas we have with sort of like fake lyrics, because we give a lot of importance to the sound of the words. And that's the very, very, very beginning of the making of a new song.
Actually, it's very funny because I learn every time that the lyrics. And when we have the real lyrics, I never remember anything.
Yeah, it's like, it sounds different. I'm like, of course, because it wasn't like that. I mean, the lyrics are completely different and it was like weirded out by that.
Yeah, we work separately. Like, I collect my own ideas at home and Christina collects her own. And then when we meet here with Marco, we listen to all the ideas and we choose the ones that are more, that are better and more convincing for the songs. And we don't really care who wrote the part or how many parts I wrote or she wrote. We care that this is sound best for the result of the song, you know, for the sound of the overall.
Yeah, we always say that we use our two voices as additional instruments. As Andrea said, there is no ego. For us, the most important thing is the song, how it will be coming out, of course, the best we can. So that's the goal for us.
I'm here in Milan finally recording the new album. It's amazing, it's a very great feeling I have, and this recording process is one of the things I love most in my job, you know, even though sometimes it's getting like sometimes frustrating, because it's always hard to find the right thing and to put it at the right place, you know. But as life teaches, like, great goals don't come easy, so it's always a fight for me. Since I was a kid, I started to play, to crash basically pans and pots of my grandma, you know. And since then, since the very first time I've listened to like rock music, I started to play drums. And I'm pretty sure I will never stop. I have to say that also this is one of those things that, in my opinion, makes a drummer become legendary and not great. That doesn't mean I'm a legendary drummer, I just don't mean that. And I just want to say that I'm trying to reach that goal, you know, to make the people really feel what I want to tell with my drumming. Song is like a box, so after a while the box gets full, so you must know when is your time to stop putting stuff in the box. That's my secret.
I actually decided to start playing guitar when I was about 15, and it happened when I watched a video by Dire Straits, Money for Nothing. I asked my dad, who's also been playing guitar for many years, to teach me a few chords and stuff like that. And that was basically it. I started listening to all the records and the music that my parents had in the house. And I slowly taught myself, basically, how to play. And that was what happened, pretty much, and it kept going like that. None of them lying preachers cannot curse me anymore. As a guitarist, I like to try and play as much diverse stuff as I can. I really like heavy guitars as well as like more melodic and maybe clean, cleaner parts. As I said, I mean, being a pretty lazy person in general, I don't play nearly enough as I would like to, which makes it hard sometimes to maybe get to play a part as well as I wish I could. On the other hand, I'm actually really quick in learning stuff when I listen to something, which increases my laziness a lot. Which is a good and a bad thing at the same time. Luckily, I'm able to play nearly everything that I want with Lacuna Coil, and so actually I'm pretty happy with how I play, but I still wish that sometimes I could just sit down and just like play a super fast lick or something like that, which unfortunately I have to play a lot of times before I can get right. From inside, when we scare away reality, when walls are falling down, we are alone, we are the night, we are the ghost that got you.
Hi everybody, this is Mouse from Lacuna Coil, guitar player. Ooh. I started with this instrument because I was very influenced by legendary bands like, for example, Megadeth or Iron Maiden, Pantera, this kind of stuff.
Yeah, it's still a tuning.
And I started when I was 15 with a classical guitar. Then I moved with a electric guitar, and since now I'm 36, so that's it. I'm already happy about the result that I reached in these years, but of course I would love to be a better guitar player. I would love to give to the people more sensations, more you know, always related with the music. I would love to improve a lot of techniques, but of course it takes time and a lot of passion as well.
Led me to sing? That's an interesting question, because I never really thought I would have become a professional singer at first, but I always loved to sing. I kind of knew that I wanted to sing for the rest of my life, and the fact that to sing became my life and my profession, it's fantastic. I mean, I couldn't have wished for more. I got you. What kept me playing all these years? Definitely the passion for music. I mean, I really, 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 really love to sing. And this is something I realized even more recently, because it happened that I've been for like a week with no voice at all, probably for like a virus or something. And I just realized that I literally sing pretty much all day long, from morning to tonight, and it really hurt to not to be able to sing, you know, to try to sing and nothing comes out, and you're like, ah! It was really torturing for me. So once again, I realized that this is something I want to do forever, and I hope it will never happen anything bad to this.
I started singing more or less 20 years ago. Me and Marco, our bass player, we were skateboarders, and when we couldn't go out skating, we were just playing and jamming to our favorite songs in his house. So we were basically just having fun with our favorite records, music from bands like Black Flag or Slayer, Metallica, Iron Maiden, Anthrax. So we started really, really for fun, and I was just singing because I couldn't play the guitar, so I was just singing. And then I got more and more into the passion of singing, even if I never really cared about being a professional singer. It was something we were just doing for fun, and because we had time and where we couldn't skate, and so we just did it because we like it. And that's how we started, and that's how I started singing. no matter how long you study for, no matter how hard you put into the studying, but you'll never be as good as somebody that has natural talent, you know. It's a big difference. Maybe a natural talent will never be able to reach certain notes or certain speeds or something like that, but the way his talent will flow will never be comparable to somebody that has just been practicing and practicing over and over. You know, you need both. You need to practice and you need some talent, and people that can combine the two and have the continuity, you know, the intensity to keep going all the time and keep studying and keep practicing, that's the people that's gonna reach the best level, and those are the people that's gonna be the stars, you know. There are just a few people which can combine the natural talent with the ability and the persistence of practicing. Those are the people that's gonna always stand out more than everybody else. But both things are good. It's good if you can play with your ear, it's good if you can play because you've studied. But I think the combination of the two is really the best.
Cosa mi ha portato a fare musica? Onestamente, la passione probabilmente che mi ha tramandato mio padre. Lui suonava il basso e suonava l'armonica a bocca. È sempre stato un appassionato di rock music, AC/DC, Purple, Iron Butterfly, tutti questi gruppi che lo ascoltava, e da lì è iniziata un po' la passione. Diciamo che da quello ho chiesto a mio padre una volta se potevo rubargli il basso per poter iniziare a strimpellare qualcosina, e così è stato. Ho iniziato fondamentalmente per hobby e divertimento, e poi con Andrea ho iniziato a fare un micro gruppettino da camera, nel vero senso della parola, nel senso della camera da letto. Ci siamo messi a suonare e poi da lì è nato fondamentalmente tutto. Non ho mai studiato musica, sono sempre stato autodidatta, perché fondamentalmente non ho voglia di fare un cazzo! Quello che ho fatto fino adesso mi ha dato soddisfazioni, tante. Soddisfazioni che non sono monetarie o di fama a livello che fai in giro e ti saltano addosso tutti e chiedono autografi. Soddisfazione perché c'è tanta gente nel mondo che ha comprato i nostri dischi, ha ascoltato le nostre canzoni e anche con una stretta di mano, quando le incontri durante i concerti, ti fanno capire quanto sei importante per loro. Questa è una grossa soddisfazione.
Cosa penso del disco nuovo? Ma secondo me il disco nuovo è gran figo, sai?
Jay Baumgartner, and I'm here in Milan, Italy, and I'm producing a new album for Lacuna Coil.
My name is Kyle Hoffman. I am the engineer for the new Lacuna Coil album, and I'm from Los Angeles, California.
We've been here in Milan working on the album for the last few weeks, and we're really having a great time, and the band is really good. We're really making some great music, and I hope everybody's going to enjoy it when they get to hear the new album.
So when we came to Milan, we were, you know, we didn't really, I had no idea what to expect in terms of what kind of studio we were going to record in, you know. And we showed up at Officine Meccaniche, and I was very surprised with the quality of the instruments and the gear and the board and everything.
I met the guys in the band a few years ago when they were in LA recording at NRG at my studio.
You know, these guys were really great. I had a really good time recording with them, and you know, everybody, we all got along really, really well. It was just a really fun time.
Thank you guys for watching, and see you next time.
Rock on.
Rock on.
Ciao, ciao.
Ciao. Let's make it the soundtrack of your life.
Bye.